This is the HClO4 Lewis structure, perchloric acid. When we see the H in front bonded to this polyatomic ion here, we know it's going to be an acid. That means we'll put the H here on the outside of one of these oxygen atoms. Chlorine is less electronegative than oxygen, so we'll put it at the center and then put the oxygens around it. Let's put that hydrogen outside of this oxygen right here, and now we have all the atoms in a skeleton structure. The HClO4 Lewis structure has a total of 32 valence electrons. We'll put a pair of electrons between atoms to form chemical bonds. We've used 10 valence electrons, and then around the outer atoms to fill their octets, 12, 14, and 32. So we've used all 32 valence electrons, and each atom in the HClO4 Lewis structure has a full outer shell. So it looks like this is a pretty good Lewis structure for HClO4. However, chlorine is below period 2 on the periodic table. That means it can have an expanded octet. It can hold more than 8 valence electrons. So we need to look at the formal charges to make sure that this is the best Lewis structure for HClO4. For the central chlorine atom, we have 7 valence electrons on the periodic table, minus non-bonding, all these electrons here, they're bonding, so we have 0, minus bonding, 2, 4, 6, 8, that's 8 over 2, so our formal charge for that chlorine is plus 3. The oxygens, these three are the same, so let's just do one of those. Oxygen is in group 6 on the periodic table. It has 6 valence electrons, minus non-bonding, 6 non-bonding, minus bonding. We have 2, which we'll divide by 2, for a total of negative 1. That's the formal charge on these three oxygens. The formal charges on this oxygen here, that's 0, and the hydrogen has a formal charge of 0 as well. So clearly, we'd like our formal charges to be closer to 0. To do that, we can form a double bond with the oxygen and the chlorine right here. We'll move these two valence electrons here to the center and share them. When we recalculate our formal charges, chlorine now has a plus 2, so it's been decreased by 1, and the oxygen has a formal charge of 0. So we'll need to form double bonds on this oxygen and this oxygen to bring those to 0 and the chlorine. So we're still using the 32 valence electrons we have for the HClO4 Lewis structure, but now we have these double bonds here. Chlorine has more than 8, but that's okay because it can have an expanded octet. The formal charges for each of the atoms is 0, and for the whole structure it's 0, which is a much more stable and plausible Lewis structure for HClO4. So we're done. This is the Lewis structure for HClO4. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.